Hey everybody, welcome back to my layout.
This will be a layout update for March 2018. I got a few new things to show you guys before we take a look at what's new on the layout. Just a quick note about the lead unit on today's train. This SD60F, I'm pretty sure it's getting cut up for scrap kind of as we speak right now, so figured I'd put my HO scale version in lead duties today as a little tribute. So that's why this one's leading the train today. So the first new piece of rolling stock we got this past month, I stopped on my way home in Calgary at the trains and such, just a local hobby shop there. They have a pretty good used section. I found this 40-foot boxcar for 10 bucks. So I grabbed that for my little guy, and he was so excited with it. He played with it all afternoon, and then he actually slept with it that night. So he was pretty happy with that little boxcar that he got. So this is his old school Roundhouse products, if you remember the old packaging on these guys. Nice little box car. It's perfect for him. It's all kind of one piece molding, so he can be pretty rough with it and doesn't hurt it. So that was the first new item we got. So the other thing I found when I was at that train store was a pair of these old Walthers 6200 cubic foot plastic pellet cars, and a pair of them for 40 bucks used. They've got the old plastic wheel sets on them, but I'll change those out for metal ones and put some good couplers on them. And they should be some neat cars to run on the layout. I've been looking for these for years, and I never came across them until now. They're nice cars. We see them quite often here in central Alberta. Throw a couple pictures on. It's a pretty neat paint scheme. So those are a couple of the used items I found at the train store. Another thing that came in is the Rapido 3800 cubic foot hoppers. So let's take a look at those. So these are the new Rapido trains 3800 cubic foot hoppers, cylindrical hopper cars. We got a few in the different modern schemes. This is like the Procore blue word mark. And we'll just roll them by here and take a close look at the modern versions that I bought.
Mine is the Mine is the table dance stuff.
Sure. So Rapido calls this one the CN Wet Noodle Gray. Okay. So I got a few of those. This is the CN, what do they call this one, Max? CN Wet Noodle Mineral Brown. And these are all in phosphate rock service. You see them a lot in Jasper.
Here's the green one.
Okay.
I'm
going to
take this one right here.
What's this one called? And Rapido calls this Procore one, just a blue logo, but it's has the normal Procore blue word mark on it. So I got a few of those Procore ones, and then I just got one of these. They call this the As Delivered with the big red CN noodle. It's kind of an off grayish green color. Just got one of those to kind of, maybe it'll be like an old one that's really weathered. So pretty nice cars from Rapido Trains. I haven't had any issues with them. I've heard some people having issues with the trucks being warped, but haven't seen that on any of mine yet. I mean, I've only been running them around the loop, so I haven't really tested them out that much, but haven't had any issues with mine yet. So that's it for new rolling stock over the last month. So let's take a look at what I've been working on the layout, and I've also got a project on my workbench right now. So I started working on this other Rapido BC Rail Dash 8 that I've got. Just started the basic stuff on it, like putting the 5-chime horn on there, and I drill out the bells on each horn, as well as I sanded down the stack and lowered it so it looks more prototypical. And now I'm just at the point where I'm going to put the ditch lights on, so I just wanted to show you that kind of how I do it. Some guys had asked about the last one, so. So the way these Rapido ditch light housings come, I found this is the easiest way for me to do it. I'm not sure, there's probably other ways that people do it, but I just very carefully pre-drill the holes in these pilot support brackets. So just very carefully, and make sure I pre-drill them once with a smaller bit so that I can get the hole exactly center.
It's really important with ditch lights, I find, to try and make sure these are in the exact spot where you want them. So I pre-drill them with a small drill bit, and then I drill them out with a bigger drill bit. And you can see they're pretty close. This one might be a little bit off, but you can... I drill the hole a little bit bigger, so there's some play there when I go to glue them on. And I can try and get them centered and straight and everything. So those are the holes in the pilot. So then the next step will just be gluing the LED housings in there and threading the wire through. These are the housings that come from Rapido. So all I do is they send these in what I call a ditch light configuration. So the leads come off perpendicular to the way the light shines out of the diode. So all I do is put a 90 degree bend on them, and then I drill a hole through the housing, same size as the front light here. And then once the glue is set, I just use normal CA glue. Once the glue is set, I just paint the back of the housings, and being very careful not to get too much paint in there, because then it'll cover up the LED and then you'll have problems. But that's all I do. You can see the back of this one. And if there's a little bit of gap, I think this one had quite a big gap around the diode. So what I did was just took a little bit of fun tack and just kind of used it as a gap filler and then painted it black. So those are ready to get put onto the model. So that's the step that I'm at now. Just one other thing I want to show quickly about these BC Rail-8s. Precision Design Company came out with this decal set for the BC Rail-8s, and it is absolutely fantastic. $25 and you can do any road number of the 26 units that were produced. So that is really cool, and it's got even there's slight differences between the units. You know, some of them have like duct tape for back number boards, and one of the main things that I like about it is you can see 4622 was the last road number of the first order, and 4623 was the first unit of the second order. So you can see they got the different rear road numbers for it, as well as different road numbers on the number boards, and even the electrified territory stickers. So that is really cool. I'll leave a link in the video description, but definitely an awesome product. Really improves on the pretty crappy decals from Rapido that they provided with these models. And you got the portholes for the doors, so really, really nice product from Precision Design Co. So over here on the layout, I was working mainly just on the lighting valence, getting that done. So the lighting valence is finished now, all the way around the CP side of the layout. So it is finished around. I had another, 40 feet or so here. This is all done now. And this turned out really nice. And all I did was that same method I was talking about in the last update. I made a plywood template just by tracing the bottom of the benchwork here. And then I basically just attached that to the roof and used that to attach the quarter inch hardboard to. So in places where there was a lot of tension and the valence was either kind of bent in too much, like leaning down and in, or bent outwards, I added some of these triangular supports, just pieces of scrap plywood I had laying around, and I just primed them white, and that helped. I kind of just went around the whole thing, especially in the corners, especially down here. There's a lot of tension in this big bend down there. So that helped, make it more even and help the bend form along the whole vertical section of that. And I found they're absolutely necessary, especially in places that have these big 90 degree bends. So they came in, they worked really well in helping square that up. I'll include a couple pictures just to kind of slideshow format, just to show how I attach these. I just used my clamps to kind of push the angled corner in and make it square. And then I just let it sit for like 24 hours and let the glue dry. But there's no hardware holding those in, it's just glue.
So now that the valence is done, I'm moving ahead with the next step, which is lighting. So you can see I've just barely started over here. There's some of that L-bracket, just aluminum siding. I got white because obviously it blends in there with the painted backdrop of the valence. And I'm stapling it as I go. And this is what I'm going to attach the LED strip lights to eventually. So I haven't made much progress there, but that's kind of my main focus here for the next month. One little note about the L bracket. It works fantastic on straight sections, obviously, but if you're going to do curves, which I have a lot of, you have to notch it like this, and that will allow you to allow the bracket to take the bend and give you something solid to attach the LED strips to. So anywhere I have a curve, you can see here, that piece is going to be going up here on this curve. Quite a sharp curve. So that's what I have to do. I'm just using tin snips and notching those out so that I can make that bend. These two drivers are the main power supplies for the entire CP side of the layout lighting. They're each 600 watts, and that makes them about 1.3% kind of oversized. The LED strips say that you should oversize your drivers by at least 1.2% so that they're not running at like 100% output. So these things will be running about 70% of their full output. So then they'll be running a little bit cooler. It's kind of an optimum efficiency type thing. So you have to select a magic number. You don't want to be too oversized because then you're just wasting money. But you don't want to be undersized either because then you're going to be radiating a lot of heat and pushing them really hard. These are made by Meanwell. It's a Taiwanese company. Seemed like a pretty good fit for what I'm doing. They're going to use 0 to 10 volt DC dimming. And the reason there's two is if you go back, if you remember back quite a few layout updates ago, my LED strip lights have two circuits in them. One of them is a yellow type light, 3200 Kelvin, and the other is a 6500 Kelvin, a blue type of light. So one driver will be for the yellowish light and the other's for the bluish light, and they each have their own dimmer that's over by the door. So the theory is we'll be able to change the lighting color and temperature just by dimming the output of these two dimmers. So that'll wrap up this layout update, guys. Plans for the next month are just to kind of push ahead with lighting. And I didn't really talk about it in this update, but the backdrop, I've decided I'm going to paint it kind of like a light sky blue. And I'll get into that in the next layout update, but I've kind of started doing the Photoshop stuff for the backdrop. So in the next layout update, I'll show you how I'm going to accomplish that. And that'll be hopefully what I'm working on over the next month. So as always, thanks a lot for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.